Now, one of the commonly discussed topics these days is the proposed 20th Amendment by the JVP. In fact, JVP is planning to bring that as a private bill to the parliament. Now, we see few problems in this. The first one is the current constitution, which was introduced to the country in 1978, very clearly states the procedure one should adopt in proposing an amendment to the constitution or changing the constitution completely. When there's a standard way of doing that which is very clearly articulated, why would somebody wants to hide behind the standing orders of the parliament, which are there for a different purpose, and bring something as important as a constitutional amendment to the parliament? This is a backdoor approach. So that's something very fishy about this. Secondly, the 1978 constitution has changed a lot over the years. There has been 19 amendments up until now. And as a result of some of these amendments, like the 13th amendment and the 19th amendment, etc., the constitution's original intentions have changed. The original model has changed. It has become a very confused constitution currently. In fact, that is why the government is going through a process of introducing a new constitution, because they have identified that there's a problem. So many amendments have created so many confusions. So government felt there's a need to introduce a new constitution. So a process started. Large amount of public money has been spent over the last 3 years for this purpose. So many discussions have taken place inside the parliament and outside the parliament. So many people have given their observations. Discussions are still going on. Meanwhile, the JVP is using a backdoor approach to bring an amendment focusing on one element. One element, that is the way the president is appointed. Now, when Venerable Sobhita Thero spoke about abolishing presidency, he was not talking about changing the way the president is appointed. Now, what this amendment is trying to do is the right of the people of this country to select their president is taken away from them and given to 225 parliamentarians. And the JVP leader himself, sometimes back, said the parliamentarians can be bought for money. I don't know whom he was referring to, but he very clearly said so. He said when certain important bills are brought to the parliament, there are some parliamentarians who will change their mind and vote for one side or the other based on how much money they are given. So are we going to give this right of selecting the president of this country, this very important task, to parliamentarians who are like that? Or are we just trying to create business opportunities for them? Is it what JVP is trying to do? We suspect that JVP wants to take control of this process. Small parties like JVP, who may not have much of a say at a presidential election, will have a huge say even with two or three parliamentary seats if parliament is appointed the president. And in fact, in this new proposal, there's a clause we understand that with 50% of votes in the parliament, the president can be removed. So what kind of president are we going to appoint? We'll be appointing a president who will have to always worry about the parliament, who will not be able to work independently. Is it what this country wants? So, all in all, this whole thing is very suspicious. And also the timing is wrong. Look at the problems people are having today. The economy is down. Cost of living has gone up. Employment is down. The underworld is rising. There are so many natural disasters. People are suffering. There are deaths. The whole government administration has come to a standstill. And instead of talking about those things, the JVP is talking about the 20th Amendment as if it's the most important issue that the people are facing currently. And that is not so. We all know that. So we are very, very suspicious about this whole thing.